Welcome everyone to our Applied Clinical Research Certificate Program Preview. Thank you for taking the time to join us today. My name is Kathy Emick and I am a program manager here at McMaster University Center for Continuing Education. After my presentation, I will answer any questions that you may have about the program. Please feel free to enter your questions in the question and answer box at any point throughout this session. And just a note before we get started, this session will be made available on YouTube and our website after today's session. We will email you the link a few days after the presentation. Now let's get started. The agenda for today's preview is as follows. I will talk a bit about who we are, about the Applied Clinical Research Certificate Program, who should take this program, all of the learning objectives and outcomes of the Applied Clinical Research Program, information on taking online courses with McMaster CCE, and the admission requirements. At the end of the preview, we will have questions and answers. Before I get into details about the program, I would like to tell you a bit about who we are. McMaster University's Center for Continuing Education, which is also known as CCE, has been a part of McMaster since 1931. McMaster CCE has been engaging and inspiring the individual and the community to discover and achieve through lifelong learning. Students value our quality instructors with real-world experience and the flexibility and convenience of our course scheduling. As one of Canada's largest and leading providers of academic certificate and diploma programs, professional development education, and corporate training, McMaster CCE's purpose is to develop and realize the potential of both individuals and society by providing the education to thrive in a dynamic world. We are proud to be ranked within the top 100 universities in the world. Now you will hear about the benefits of this program from an employer's perspective.
Hello, my name is Donna McCarty. I'm the Clinical Research Manager in the Ontario Clinical Oncology Group within the Department of Oncology, Faculty of Health Sciences at McMaster University. Clinical research provides valuable scientific information for evaluating the effectiveness of techniques and therapies used in the prevention, diagnoses, and treatment of diseases and disorders, as well as identifying any potential harm to study participants. Credible study results require careful execution and management of a research protocol. Within our research unit, the multidisciplinary research coordination team consists of clinical research managers, research coordinators, research assistants, clinical research associates, data management specialists, ethics and regulatory affairs staff, statisticians, and physician research associates. We work closely with study investigators, physicians, to conceive, design, coordinate, conduct, analyze, and publish clinical trials. We establish and implement mechanisms required to conduct clinical trials in an efficient, scientifically rigorous manner, ensuring adherence to regulations and good clinical practice guidelines, as well as established internal SOPs and quality assurance programs. Day-to-day activities include planning, implementing, and evaluating research study procedures as per the clinical trial protocol, and managing the operations of clinical trials, ensuring that all aspects of the research protocol are adhered to, as well as compliance with regulations and good clinical practice guidelines. Specific activities include protocol development, preparation and submission to Health Canada and US FDA regulatory agencies, facilitation and tracking of ethics submissions and approvals, contract preparation, overall study management and monitoring, as well as data management, including quality assurance, monitoring of trial progress, collection and verification of clinical data. The Applied Clinical Research Program provides students with the knowledge and a practical approach to manage and coordinate clinical trials. As a clinical research manager of an academic clinical trials coordination and method center, the value that this program offers includes learning outcomes such as knowledge of regulations that govern clinical trials, along with good clinical practice guidelines, knowledge of phases of clinical trials and different types of research study designs, ethical guidelines related to the involvement of human participants in research, learning the historical reasons for the development of research ethics and regulations, characteristics of an effective research question, an understanding of clinical trial design, including protocol development and preparation of a schedule of assessments, the importance of privacy and confidentiality in research, responsibilities of the study team from the perspective of sponsors, investigators, academic coordination and method centers, as well as participating sites, including the overall committee structures, trial monitoring and data management from clinical trial startup, recruitment, follow-up, closeout, and analysis, recruitment and retention of study participants, the role and responsibilities of the research coordinator or CRA in managing the clinical trial. When assessing potential candidates for a position in our research unit, one of the first questions we ask is, if you are provided with a research study protocol, what are the steps necessary to operationalize that protocol? What type of study is it? What is the intervention? Does it require Health Canada or FDA submission? How will we evaluate the study outcomes? How do you define the data collection requirements? What are the safety outcomes and how will these be monitored? Who is involved in regard to study committees? Who would you need to work with? Do you need to involve any outside agencies? An example might be a central lab for biospecimen collection. Additionally, what are the timelines related to all aspects of the clinical trial, from startup, recruitment, follow-up, to closeout? How will you monitor and track the progress and identify any barriers to successful completion of the trial? Monitoring study execution, particularly with regard to methodological aspects and ensuring each participating clinical site adheres to the study protocol, is vital to the successful conduct of a clinical trial. This program provides students with the knowledge of regulations and guidelines, as well as ethical requirements. It provides the elements of clinical trial design to gain the ability to operationalize a research protocol. In addition, it provides an overview of logistics necessary to manage the clinical trial and ensure the trial is meeting its targets and timelines.
Now we will move on to discuss this program's learning objectives and course outcomes. Program learning objectives and specified course outcomes align with the Association of Clinical Research Professionals Knowledge Domains, known as ACRP. They are operations, GCP, which is good clinical practice, communication and teamwork, data management in informatics, ethical and participant safety considerations, leadership and professionalism, scientific concepts and research design, study and site management. These are the five main learning outcomes for the Applied Clinical Research Program. Upon completion of the certificate, students will be able to describe GCP, which is good clinical practice, requirements, and explain the legal and regulatory issues in clinical research. Understand the process of protocol development and critique flawed and exemplary studies. Differentiate the key elements of successful study and site management. Examine ethical issues in clinical research and select appropriate approaches and strategies to navigate. Practice the leadership and communication skills needed in a clinical research setting. The Applied Clinical Research Certificate Program consists of 5 3-unit level courses, and students must complete all 5 courses, which are 15 units, in order to earn the ACR certificate. Students are given a 3-year period to complete all required components of the certificate program. This requirement is based on the need to remain current with legal, regulatory, and ethical considerations in the field of this work. Courses offered under CCE's Applied Clinical Research Certificate are university-level courses that are designed at the second and third year undergraduate level. Students who have completed a CCE certificate program may be eligible to apply up to 15 units of credit earned towards degree studies at McMaster in accordance with the academic rules specified by the faculty offering the degree. Now let's dive deeper into the program and discuss the 5 required courses. Courses must be taken in the following order: Principles of Clinical Research first, Research Ethics, Clinical Trial Design, Clinical Trial Management, and Clinical Research Capstone, which is the final course. Each course will bridge theory and practical experience through a combination of experiential learning, example, case studies, discussions, podcasts, quizzes, and traditional teaching methods. After taking the first four courses, students will complete a capstone project as the final course in the program, which provides the opportunity to apply the clinical research methods, techniques, and strategies to a real-world situation. Emerging trends, theories, and practices are incorporated to coursework to ensure that program content is current and relevant. Students may enroll in the clinical research capstone course while completing their fourth and final course. The Applied Clinical Research Certificate Program is fully online. The ACR courses are asynchronous, which means that you do not have to be online at a specific time during the week, as long as you're online through the week to contribute to discussion boards and meet assignment deadlines. It's important that you consider the learning format and its suitability for you in order to ensure that you have successful learning experience. The Center for Continuing Education uses the Learning Management System, Brightspace, which is Desire to Learn, to deliver its online courses. McMaster uses the term Avenue to Learn for the learning management system. The ACR program does not have final exams and textbooks are not required. To view our course schedule online or to enroll, please go to our website, which is www.mcmastercce.ca. Students can enroll online up to the first day of the course, but it's highly recommended that you enroll early to avoid disappointment. Some great features of the Applied Clinical Research Program include part-time studies so you can still work and complete your studies. Online learning allows you to study from home and offers the flexibility to complete course activities on your schedule. You can collaborate with learners from across Canada with varying levels of experience. You can maintain continuous study, build on the momentum of each course. Students who wish to enter the Certificate in Applied Clinical Research program should meet the following requirements based on their education and work experience: equivalent academic experience, such as university degree, college diploma with relevant coursework in science or health science, with a minimum grade point average of C- or better, or relevant professional experience, minimum of 3 years, or related professional certification in the field of clinical research, or be a mature student as defined in the undergraduate calendar of McMaster University, or be deemed an exceptional case by the Center for Continuing Education. The English language proficiency is completion of TOEFL exam with minimal acceptable score of IBT, 86 overall with a minimum score of 20 on each of the four components, which are reading, writing, speaking, listening, and it's valid for 2 years. Prospective students should contact the program manager for consultation and evaluation of past education and professional experience. The online enrollment process is straightforward and it only takes a few minutes to complete. If paying by credit card or debit, you can enroll online at www.mcmastercce.ca. Simply follow the prompts after clicking Enroll Today. Payment is on a per-course basis. In other words, if you enroll in two courses, you will be expected to pay in full for two courses at the time of enrollment. For new students, there is a one-time non-refundable fee of $39 that is charged the first time you enroll with CCE. Even if you were a McMaster degree student but have never taken a course through CCE before, you will still be charged the CCE activation fee. Enrollment deadline for online courses is up to the first day of the course. After you click Enroll Today, you'll be taken to a course search page where you can search by program and program plan to find available courses for the upcoming semester. On this screen, you will see the courses that we are offering for any upcoming semesters that are open for enrollment. Once you have finished selecting your courses, you can check out and either log in as a returning student with your Mac ID and password, or as a new student by creating a new user account. Once you have a Mac ID and password, you will have access to your student portal called Mosaic Student Center. Mosaic is used for many registrar office services, like requesting an official transcript, viewing an unofficial transcript, dropping a course, viewing your final grade, or printing off a letter of enrollment or letter of completion. On the main page of our website, you will find a link to some helpful how-to videos on how to use our enrollment system, along with other Mosaic tips. Should you have any questions, you can contact us by either email, website, or calling our service center. You are welcome to ask us specific questions anytime via the phone, our website, or email. Our information specialists are available to assist you to answer any questions you may have, so do not hesitate to contact us as you prepare to enroll. Well, this concludes the information session for the Applied Clinical Research Program. I want to thank everyone for attending the session. Again, you will be emailed the link to the recorded version of this presentation in a couple of days. So if you missed any information item, don't worry, you can review the presentation again. At this time, I will begin to scroll through questions that have been submitted during the session. So if you want to remain to hear the questions and responses, please do so. If not, you are welcome to exit, and thanks again for attending.